everybody, Shelly here. I just wanted to come on today and let you know that today's video is going to be 30 minutes of real-time painting. So if you don't want to watch that slow of a process, then go ahead and skip to the last 5 minutes of the video, and there you can see the faster time-lapse type painting just to finish off the face here of our first cowboy. I'm going to be working on this full painting. It's called Loaded. I've got these awesome three cowboys that are going to be in it, and as it progresses, I'll show you some of the painting process that happened along the way. All right, guys, hope you enjoy it. Thanks.
All right, we're gonna start the face of cowboy number one. So I've got a dried underpainting here. I did that with transparent oxide red and a little bit of viridian green mixed together. So I got this nice brown color. So, let's see. I am going to start as far away. My initial brush strokes. I'm going to try to just lay those down like I do with my usual selective start method. This side of the face is gonna be getting lost in the underside of his cowboy hat, which is very dark as well. So let me go ahead and put that in. I'm just using some straight Van Dyke brown. Now it comes down to about right here, as you can see in my underpainting. When I put the background in, I lost a little bit of the shape of it. And this comes up at an angle. And I'd say it's about a 2 o'clock. 2 o'clock. Interesting thing with this painting is it's not a portrait, so I don't have to worry about getting the likeness exact. In fact, because my reference material was shot at the American Frontier Productions, there's a lot of other artists who have gone here and shot these exact same cowboys. Not necessarily in these exact same compositions, but their faces are gonna be getting pretty well known. So I'm thinking I might want to not actually capture his portrait so exact. Want to just let it go a little bit so that it just looks like some really interesting rugged cowboy guy. So since I lost how far out his hat comes, the way that we're going to figure this out is we're going to do it by comparative measuring. So, I'm going to see from his nose to the edge of the hat is the same distance as from under, from the edge of his face to about his sideburn. So from here to here should equal the distance from here to here to his hat. So it needs to come out about there. So that is comparative measuring. You're comparing two things together. And that's a good place to start as far as the brim of the hat goes, and we can always adjust it down the road. Okay, I'm gonna work my way up into this forehead. So all of this forehead here is in the shadow, which is being cast by the hat. Paint on pretty thin, and that way I can build up layers. You always want to put your thicker layers on top of thin layers, and that will continue to meet up with the fat over lean rule. That shadow is being cast all the way down to about there. So just pull a little bit of that over. I'll put in this other eyebrow. So remember how I don't actually want to capture my cowboy's portrait. So one of the ways to do that is to not copy identically the position of his eyebrows. If you really want to capture the likeness of someone, you need to get their position of their eyebrows correct. So I'm saying that the opposite of that should help me not capture the exact likeness of my cowboy. I'm liking the texture of this wood panel that I've got here. It's a birch wood panel, and I sanded it, glued it, let that dry, and it's got several coats of gesso that were sanded, but it still has this really neat texture to it. And I like the way it's making his face look rugged. I'm gonna grab a little bit of this Terra Rosa. I feel like the edge of this nose is very hot. So I'll work with that. That's seems too light.
Too light.
Let's just keep putting a little bit of our shadow color over it till we like it. There we go. Okay. I'm gonna mix a little bit of our neutral dark and our hot dark. We're gonna meet in the middle here. And put in this eye, which doesn't have a lot of definition to it. You can barely see it. It's just kind of hanging out there in the eye socket. There we go. All right. So this part of the nose, a little lighter and not so much in the shadow area. Grab a little of this color here, this coming in towards the eye socket. Pretty big shadow there. Okay. A little more of this Terra Rosa. See what I mean by making new colors out of our initial piles? That's what happens. As you're laying down brush strokes, you can make adjustments as you need to. In this Rosemary Eclipse Filbert brush, it's a number 4. Bristles aren't too stiff like hog's hair, but they're also not as soft as sable. I had not painted with it until recently, and now it's sort of my go-to brush. Hanging in about right there. One thing I do want to capture is he's looking out, like out onto the horizon. Each of my cowboys has got a different direction that they're gazing into. Let's make sure we get that. Gaze there. I like using flesh tones for the so-called whites of the eye. I'm gonna get a little bit of this lighter color and mix it into this guy, this underlid. This should be lighter in value than the white of the eye. So we're going to darken that. Let's use my little brush. I'm going to get some of that dark middle value. There we go. So it's darker than the under part. Just grab some straight Van Dyke brown. See if we can't get this gaze up. There we go. Mm-hmm. eyelid flesh color to meet the lash line. There we are. Step back and take a look at that. Asking myself, is that eye coming far enough back? And I feel like it is. So the underneath eyelid is protruding outward slightly. This part is in shadow because it's pushing inward and towards the eye socket. And there's a little bit of shadowy color underneath here. There we go. Might be a little dark. We don't want it to look like he got in a fight. Or do we? No, we don't. Okay. Judge that better when we get some more flesh in here. And back to my number 4 Eclipse Filbert. Side of the nose up a little bit. It's got more light hitting it. Coming out from underneath the hat. There's the nostril area, and that's the upper part of his nose. Okay, let's see about the underneath part. So it looks like there's light bouncing up, but in order to have more of a 3D effect, I want some shadow underneath here. So I'm putting in the shadow. And nostril curves around about right here. All the way back there. Now the opening of nostrils are usually quite warm, so I'm going to add some heat to that. Bit of heat to this shadow color just here underneath. Now I'm gonna get a little lighter and warmer right here. It's a great place to add a little touch of heat. Help balance out the heat there, heat there, heat there. can see ever so slightly a little bit of cheek peeking out right here. Just slightly. Which is lighter than the underneath part of the nose. So let's darken this so we can differentiate between the two shapes. I'm not even thinking of them as things. They're just shapes to me right now. And that shape that way. Lighten this up just a scotch. That's too much. I always do that. Bit of push and pull here. We'll get it. Okay. See a little bit of that cheek poking in here just as it moves into that mustache. Pretty thick. I don't even see any skin poking through it, so we don't have to worry about bringing any of the flesh color in there. Coming around on the cheek. Now this side of the face is quite light. Remember when we were checking initially, it had quite a bit of light to it. And it went all the way up into here. And this part of the cheek was warmer and a little darker. Now, typically, the nose is a really vascular feature on the face. The skin is thin, so the blood runs close to the surface of the nose, which means you're usually gonna see a bit more red from the blood. It's lying just underneath the skin. So I like to pull a little more red into this bridge of the nose. Just where we're coming around here on the edge of it. This is going to be one of those areas where you have a light against a dark edge. But I don't want this edge of his nose to be super hard. So I'm really thinking about the brush strokes that I'm putting down right now. And keeping them painterly. Too blended, not too worried about the perfect edge of his nose. I want it to be a little on the rough side. I'm gonna build up a little highlight here. Grab a little more white for that highlight there. Okay. I just want to get some definition on this nostril here. See the shape and the volume in this nostril. I'm keeping these marks pretty warm in color. We're going to transition from this warm cheek color towards the lighter, cooler, bright part of the side of his face. Okay. Overlap brush strokes just slightly, but I'm not blending them together. And that guy is just right next to the other brush stroke. Some areas, like right here in the upper part of this little cheek, I'm gonna let that little bit of warmth come through from the underpainting. I like the way it looks. So I'm gonna leave that pretty open there. Typically, your lighter areas, lighter flesh tone areas, are gonna be thicker paint. And you're gonna be building those up with different layers of paint. Now, we're in this neutral area. If you remember when we were mixing it, this cheek area was pretty kind of just tannish. And I feel like that needs a little more yellow now that I see it laid down. And I'm gonna lighten it a little bit with titanium white. We're going to be putting some of those dark whiskers on top of this color. I want to have the skin down and then paint the whiskers on top. The light side of his face. So just make sure not to transition so hard. There we go. So I'm wiping my brush off in between dabs into my paint piles. Okay. keeps your paint clean. So we're getting warmer and darker in value as we move up here, the temples. Liking that. And again, I'm going to let some of this underpainting stand and show through for the shadowy, warm color up there by the hat brim. It's getting a little neutral again as we're coming down. Side of the face. Very neutral over here by the jaw and ear. That got a little warm, I mean a little neutral and a little light. So let's fix that. There we go. A little dab will do ya. A little dab will do. Ooh, too light. Snap dragons.